Thank you. Mark my words.
Smell it. But there's an even greater service you can perform.
The strangest thing happened to me earlier. He said that while the Inquisition made matters worse in Brightwood, it was not the source of the curse. Indeed, Bankole hinted that the curse is in the bones of the land, and then he left.
Oh, Dee! Oh, you startled me!
Thank you. Okay. I've heard legend. I was duped. I thought I was part of a great cause, a holy mission. Story of my life, really. The other knights and I were chasing relics stolen from Jerusalem by sea. And by sea, like fools, we pursued them. I'm not sure they ever even existed. Our knight commander turned out to be... not a trustworthy man. After a storm, we ended up shipwrecked on a strange beach. Many drowned. But I've always been a strong swimmer. Is it the lucky man who outlives every cause he's ever joined? Emil the Lucky, they can call me. Ah, but enough gloom, I think. Aeternum offers new causes and eternal life to boot. Both of us are very lucky.
How refreshing to see the factions put aside their differences in pursuit of a greater goal. Think of what we could accomplish if this was a norm. Providence, destiny, the hand of Lady Fortuna herself. Also, I would say if I weren't a man of rationality. Still, as the cannonballs hit the ship and the water rose, I admit I raised a prayer or two. The Spanish, I think. I don't really follow politics. I was on my way to Oxford to lecture on avian anatomy, you know, when the ship carrying me across the channel suddenly stopped carrying me across the channel. Presumably, that's what ships do when they've got big holes in them. Don't you see? Everything acts according to observable, rational principles. Ships sink, birds fly, and Azoth would... It must have rules as well. Inconceivable! Just because we don't understand the rules yet doesn't mean they don't exist. It's a scientist's job to reveal them. Yes, there's so much to learn, and all the time in the world to do it.
Welcome home. I've been busy recruiting new wardens. Our little family is growing by the day. I don't suppose you had any luck with the plague people, did you? Bright skies and blasted mines, you astound me. Perhaps this little scheme could work out. It needs to yield results quickly. The Tempest's strength is growing. The Corrupted are still coming south in huge numbers. I should send some wardens to Great Cleve, establish a defensive line. Meanwhile, there's your faction party. I'm still a bit skeptical about these marauders. Yes, I think so. Yes, and the most aggressive from what I've been told. No hierarchy to organize them. Getting warriors like that to come to the table will be difficult. Well, I have a thought. Perhaps another one of my mad flight of fancy. One of the new recruits mentioned a secret fighting circle within the Marauders, a competition of sorts. The Marauders respect individual strength, so just what I was thinking. I say give it a shot. As Sophocles said, fortune is not on the side of the faint-hearted. Word is, those combatants all gather in Cutlass Keys. So, go show them why they should listen.
birds.